defrost. We're running the heater. We've been running it for about 30 minutes. And can you tell a bit about the difference between running very dry chips versus very, or mixed damp and dry chips?
Okay. Wood is wood, so it burns and it releases a certain number of BTUs per pound of wood matter. So different species of wood like oak or eucalyptus or pine or fir have different BTU per pound content ranging from 10,000 BTUs per pound up to about 20,000 BTUs per pound for eucalyptus, which happens to live at the top of the list, and oak is up there with a nice high BTU rating. I'm running pine and fir, which is a lot lower BTU rating, more like 10 or 12,000 BTUs. So that's the intrinsic energy content of the wood fuel. Then, if there's water in it, before it can burn, you have to vaporize or boil off the water, and that consumes a lot of energy. So some of the energy of the flames goes into drying out the wood chips that aren't all the way dry. And so you'd like to not waste your energy on drying out the chips. You want the sun to do that work for you, and then that way the burner will just go. But realities, ideals one thing and reality is sometimes and or often another. And the reality right now is I have a lot of semi-dry wood chips and a smaller amount of really dry wood chips. So I'm mixing the two in order to kind of stretch things a bit. Now, what I'm building over on the side of the burner boiler is a hot water reservoir, and on top of it will be a deck, and that will allow me then to run the wheelbarrows of wood chips right up on top of that and dump them, so that then I can just shovel the chips into the delivery barrel with a snow shovel, and that makes loading the barrel about a 2 or 3 minute operation once every other day or once a day when it's really cold. But as important is that it'll be insulated really well, but still there will be some warmth coming up through the top of the deck on top of the 2,000 gallon hot water reservoir. And that warmth will dry out the chips because I'll be able to load them up there and let them sit on top in kind of a warm environment and dry for probably 2 weeks period of time. So I'll be able to bring them up and just kind of rotate them and get them to dry out before putting them in.
So how much do you estimate the loss is going to be? I mean, you're going to have heat loss from this reservoir, and on top of the reservoir is going to be the chips. So the heat loss you have through the chips is okay because you're using it to dry out the chips. But you will have some loss on the sides and through the ground. How big of a problem do you think that is, or an issue?
It shouldn't, well, you would love for the heat loss to be zero, but that's never going to be the case. What you're using this system to do is to heat your house. Your house has 6 inches of insulation. This reservoir will have more like 12 inches of insulation. So the insulation around this tank will be better than the insulation anyone has in their home. Of course, the temperature inside the tank is higher than the temperature of a home, so that sort of balances out. And the gist is that, yes, you will have heat losses, but they're not horrible. They are certainly manageable, and that's kind of where it is. But the nice thing about the reservoir, in well, like if you had a propane boiler, then it can turn on and off and just flow the heat when you want to. But with a wood boiler, you want to run it and heat the reservoir up, and then the house heats itself by calling for heat from a thermostat every now and then, and that heat comes from the reservoir. So it's just a convenient way to do it, and it works pretty well. And with the fact that you're using a really inexpensive fuel, it makes it to where you come out far ahead. That answer your question?
It did. I think it did.
We're kind of oscillating here around 3.0.
Yep.
So sometimes it'll go lower, sometimes it'll go higher.
Yeah, so that's pretty good. 3.0 is about 60 degrees Celsius, which is, what is that in Fahrenheit? Like, let's see, 100 would be 212, and then you got to deal with the 5/9 and I don't know. That's probably 100. Yeah, 150, somewhere around there. Go do the conversion if you want to, but it's a decent temperature. You could run it hotter. The nice thing with the reservoir, again, will be that you don't care so much what the outlet temperature is any longer. Now what you're going to care about is how many BTUs per hour you're putting into the water that you're taking from the reservoir through the boiler back into the reservoir. And then you just maintain the reservoir temperature at a temperature that is ideal for heating the house, which will